A citizen journalist awarded for posting public meetings on the web is now facing serious criminal charges after recording an event that was billed as a public political rally.
Channel 2's investigative reporter Jodie Fleischer is here with questions about the timing of that indictment and how the case could include some high-ranking state officials. Jodie.
Dave, Georgia's governor and attorney general were just feet away when this happened. The attorney general even spoke out against it. The woman getting arrested captured much of it on this video. But prosecutors didn't indict her until more than a year later, when she announced she's suing the county and the officer announced he's running for sheriff.
I don't know why you're videotaping, but yes, I said that.
It seemed like an innocent joke from a state leader. Then a hand blocks the camera and the photographer is dragged away.
Jobs lost.
What is your name?
Sir? Her name is Nydia Tisdale, and you rarely see the citizen journalist without her camera. Her YouTube page has hundreds of thousands of views. She calls them Nidios of government meetings to keep the public informed.
We really appreciate having you here at Burt's Farm.
But the political organizers did not appreciate Nydia's camera at this rally in August 2014.
A campaign staffer sat down next to me and whispered in my ear saying, "You have to stop filming or leave."
She said the property owner had welcomed her. Plus, the event was advertised as open to the public. Brian Pritchard from FetchYourNews.com sat directly behind Nydia.
I still don't understand it to this day. He started lifting her physically out of the chair. She was not responding or fighting with him.
Nydia's camera kept rolling as she was dragged to a barn where Sheriff's Captain Tony Wooten twisted her arm behind her and bent her over a counter.
Please loosen your grip. I'm not going anywhere.
As soon as you decide to act like you're somebody and stop fighting with me.
I'm not fighting.
Calm down.
I'm not resisting you.
You're not now.
Less than a minute later, Wooten decides he's tired of the camera. Then we hear this.
Ow! That hurts. You're hurting me.
The head of Dawson County's Republican Party saw it.
I am sorry that people are treating you this way. This is wrong.
And outside, Attorney General Sam Olin spoke up too.
What are we hiding? There's no reason for that. That is not right.
Brian only recorded audio that day. He posted it and his pictures online, including this one of Nydia with Olin's. Georgia's First Amendment Foundation honored both last year.
What are we afraid of with a lady having a camera filming us?
As the speakers continued, Brian captured Nydia's screams in the background. Nydia was arrested and her camera confiscated.
If they did that to me with the governor there, with the attorney general there, what are they doing to others?
A year later, her attorney sent this letter announcing intent to sue the county. It noted her charges were never prosecuted. Then in November, a grand jury suddenly indicted Nydia for criminal trespass and obstruction.
Did it really take 15 months to prepare these charges, or was this an effort to derail a civil case during a political campaign?
That's right. Captain Tony Wooten is now running for Dawson County Sheriff. If Nydia is convicted, he could be the one running the jail.
This terrifies me. It really does scare me. I was doing absolutely nothing wrong.
The other journalist who was there questions why prosecutors never asked him what he saw, even though he posted pictures of the arrest. Now, Nydia says she not only plans to call him as a witness, but the attorney general and maybe even the governor. The department found the officer did nothing wrong, but when I filed an open records request, the sheriff refused to release the report.
So, Jody, do we know why she feels like they singled her out?
She doesn't. I mean, she did had the only video camera there, and that was easy to spot in the crowd. I wanted to ask Captain Wooten about that, but he didn't return my repeated phone calls, and the sheriff declined to comment because of the threat of a lawsuit.
Jody, thank you.
Thanks.